If you can learn to love a process, you will stick with it. And if you stick with a process, you will learn enough to succeed with it. So that's the point of this video that I want to share with you today, is can we turn the seven disciplines of authentic business into the seven joys of authentic business? Because if you can do that, that's really the secret to success. Because, well, every day that you're working on your business will be an experience of deep fulfillment. And you won't have to wait until you succeed one day to have a good life, because you'll be living a great life every single day that you work on your business. So that's what I'm going to discuss in this video. And I'll just kind of walk you through the seven disciplines, except I'm going to reframe them as the seven joys. Okay, so here we go. The first discipline of authentic business is joyful productivity. It's not a surprise. That's my entire worldview about how to really work in business and grow a business. Whereas when you learn business elsewhere, oftentimes, and there's my dog who just walked in. See, he's talking about the joys of business. Where is he? Somewhere. There he is. Okay, anyway. And by the way, you might be wondering, what is this? This is the cloth that I put in front of me, because that way the sound is less echoey in this room. There's a lot of walls and hard surfaces in this room, so I kind of put a cloth here that dampens. Anyway, a little bit logistical tips and tricks for video. And excuse me. So I had to cough. The seven joys. So the first discipline is joyful productivity. And that's really my entire worldview. This is why I'm able to work so consistently compared to many people who feel like they're slogging through. They have to like, oh, I don't want to work on my business. I would rather, you know, do other things, lots of other things that I can do that are more fun. But I have learned to enjoy work. Like, imagine if you could do, like, if you could learn to enjoy the work of building your business, that's really the secret of it all. Because, you know, you could either, it's like people think enjoying life means, you know, drinking wine, going on vacation, watching great shows, playing with friends and family. Yeah, of course those are enjoyable, obviously. But if you can mature enough to learn to enjoy work, learn to enjoy solving problems and doing hard things that contribute to the world and bring value to others, if you can learn to enjoy that, that's like the secret. Then you integrate the child and the adult, right? So many people, I feel like so many adults are really just children walking around in adult bodies, because they haven't learned to enjoy adult things. It's like, no, let's merge the child and the adult so that we can be integrated and be playful in our hard work, be playful in challenges, to be curious in solving problems. Because that's really like moving the world forward is not just drinking wine, going on vacations and playing with friends and family. That doesn't move the world forward. We need to move the forward by solving hard challenges, by creating things, which is not easy. Otherwise, it would already been created. And you are uniquely here on this planet at this time to create something that no one else can create except for you. And that's hard. But if you can learn to enjoy and play in that process, you've got the whole thing down. That's it. That's the whole thing. So the first discipline of authentic business is joyful productivity, which is the whole mindset of learning this thing. But let me keep going and bring more joy into the other disciplines too. The second discipline of authentic business is consistent creation of content. And this is what so many of you don't do, because you're so stuck, you're so afraid, you're so paralyzed by creating and publishing content because you haven't yet found the joy of doing it. And every time I create, I mean, right now I'm creating content right in front of you, right? I wrote a blog post about this. And when I was writing the blog post, you know, I wrote a sentence and then everything below the sentence is blank white space. And that could easily create anxiety. It could easily create fear of failure. It could create, oh, who am I to do this? I don't know what to say. I'm not smart enough. I can't say anything interesting enough to keep people keep people's attention. But I just keep writing, remembering the privilege and the honor of being able to explore my thoughts and say something that might help somebody else. So it's really consistent creation is really about content marketing. People think is a chore. People think, oh, I just got to create content, so eventually I'll get clients. What a chore. I have to do a consistent. No, I don't look at it as a chore. I look at it every single time I show up to create. It is a privilege. It is an honor to be in front of you, exploring my thoughts. I don't have a script in front of me. I'm just talking out loud, exploring my thoughts. And by practicing talking out loud and exploring my thoughts, I become better at it. I've made over 1,000 videos now like this. So now I'm quite good, but you have to practice. And the more practice you do, the better you get at it. I mean, how else are we gonna learn how to enjoy something? You practice it, you have to do it. And so the first time, the second time, and the third time is going to be the hardest, but you have to remember this. It's going to be hard before it gets easy. So you can't wait until it gets easy. You have to just go through the hard part. But even the hard part, you can try to reframe your mind in the beginning of the hard part and go, it is a privilege. It's an honor to be doing this. I get to do this and I get to explore my thoughts. I get to play with the difficulty, play with the challenge, play with the pain. It's painful. I have to agree with you. It's painful, but I play with the pain. It's not fun for me to do this right now. I got to tell you. So there's a difference between joy and fun. That's what so many people don't realize. I don't know if you realize this. There is a difference between joy and fun. There's a difference between shallow happiness, which is pleasuring the body. It's shallow. It's happy, you know, shallow. It's happy. Versus a deep happiness, which is doing something hard that feels fulfilling and playing and then reframing the whole thing so that it's even playful. It's even playful to be in pain. Can you be playful in pain? Yes, you can. You know what I mean? Like, and that's a whole other thing about, well, what if you have a chronic illness? What if you have a physical illness? Can you still play with that pain? Yes, you can. I mean, I feel like that's kind of the secret of life is learning to be, and that's a secret of, I would say, spiritual growth and maturity, is learning to bring play into pain. If the pain is purposeful, like learning to go in a purposeful direction, and even if it's painful, learning to turn that into play, learning to turn anxiety into excitement, learning to turn fear into adventure, learning to turn fear of rejection, or learning to turn lack of motivation into a challenge, into a playful challenge. And so every time I create content, it's that play. It's that play that I'm working with. Like if I was just wanting to be shallow happiness, I wouldn't be doing this right now. And you wouldn't be benefiting from this teaching, right? Okay, so that's the second discipline, second joy, is consistent content creation. All right, the third discipline / joy is paid content distribution, running ads to get your content and message out there to people. Now, a lot of people think, oh, running paid advertisements, Facebook ads, isn't that just a marketing chore? Isn't that something someone else should do it? And now I know, yes, you might not be you might be really, really slow with the technology. You might be really frustrated with it. And maybe it does make sense to outsource it to other people who can run Facebook ads for you. I have recommendations. I have several of my students who are very, very good at it. And I recommend them all the time. And they are quite more affordable than me. So please ask me for recommendations on how you can outsource your Facebook ads, because I've got good resources for you. But even if you outsource it, I think it's good for you to learn the strategy of it so that you can outsource intelligently, so you can know whether the person doing the work for you is doing good work or not. Okay, so I look at paid content distribution as being so much fun, because it is like, imagine paying an affordable fee and having your message out to the people who need to see it, who need to hear it, who are potential clients for you. Isn't that amazing that we can do that? That is what Facebook ads does for you. So that's what I do all the time. I run Facebook ads and I have fun doing it because I know it's reaching people like you. and benefiting you and making an impact every day. Even when I'm sleeping, I make an impact with my Facebook ads. So that's pretty cool. The fourth discipline of authentic business is collaboration. And I'm right now, as of September, when I'm making this video, I'm teaching a course about collaboration. And the students in the course are getting a lot out of it. And one of the students in the course, her name's Charo Pania. Thank you, Charo, for this quote. She says, if you reach out with an open heart, there's nothing to fear. And that's it. Collaborations become a joy when you realize that people actually want to collaborate. It's just that nobody reaches out to them. Yeah, nobody reaches out to me. Very few people reach out to me to collaborate. Very few. I'm usually the one reaching out to other people. Now, as I teach in my course, when you reach out to people, it needs to be some kind of parity. So if you don't have an audience like I do, a same size, similar size audience, you probably shouldn't reach out to me. Didn't make sense. In my course, I teach how to find many, many collaborators that have the similar size audience as you and all that stuff. So collaborations are fun because you get to reach out to people and they're like, oh, I'm so glad you reached out. Yes, let's do something together. And you grow each other's audiences. You grow your business together. It's a lot of fun. So collaborations, if you know how to do it, it's a lot of fun. And the fifth discipline or joy of authentic business is audience research. And why is that a joy? Why is that fun? Well, you are part of my audience. So imagine if you and I were having a conversation and I get to learn more about you. I get to learn more about what challenges you're having that I might be able to help with. I get to learn what dreams you have that I might be able to help with. That's a joyful conversation. So that's part of audience research, is having one-on-one conversations. And if, as I've mentioned before, if any of you have taken my courses before and you haven't had a meet and greet with me one-on-one, I would love to do that with you. So if you've bought my courses and I haven't had a meet and greet with you, contact me and we'll do a meet and greet so I can learn more about you. It's a half hour conversation where I get to ask you some questions to learn more about how you're trying to solve the problems that I help with, so that I can learn more. I can become more, better with my offerings, etc. So audience research is those kinds of conversations, plus maybe doing surveys of your audience. And every time you do a survey, you get some responses back, and that helps you become better about how you offer things. And that's a joyful experience. I hope you'll agree with me. So discipline or joy number six is having a rhythm of offers. If you're not consistently putting out calls to action to your audience, this is what I do for a living, you know, this is my product, this is my service, your audience thinks you just put out content because it's your hobby. And that's what some of you are stuck in that process. Oh, I put out content, but no one's buying from me. Well, it's because you're not telling them what to buy from you. You're not telling them often enough what to buy from you. So the way I want to reframe the rhythm of offers is that it's a dance. Well, rhythm. So it's a dance. Every time you put out something, you humbly offer it. But it's really, let's talk about it in terms of a dance. Every time I put out something, say, hey, will you buy it from me? I'm dancing with you. Say, hey, what do you think? Is this something that you want to, is this a move that you want to do with me? Oh, you're not interested in that move? Okay, I'll do another dance a week later or 2 weeks later. It's a dance, okay? It's like, hey, let's play together. Hey, do you want to play this game with me? Okay, now this is a different analogy. It's like playing games together. Hey, do you want to play this game with me? We like each other. You like my content. Now you want to play this game with me where you pay this thing and I get to play this game with you. We get to play together. You get to grow because of this product I created. So want to play this? Oh, you want to play? You don't want to play this? That's okay. I've got another game for you to play, you know, next month or whatever it is. So it's I've reframed the offer rhythm as a playful kind of thing, as a dance. As a, hey, I'm learning more about you by offering these things to you to see if you want to buy it from me. If you don't want to buy it, that's okay. Next month, I have something else for you to buy. You know, so it's a dance, and I get to build my business, and we get to play together whenever you buy something from me, right? So that's the offer rhythm. And then finally, the seventh discipline is, or seventh joy, is client feedback or customer feedback. My clients know I'm obsessive about getting feedback. My students know I'm obsessive. I'm always trying to get feedback. How is it going? Can I do something better to help you, to serve you? And it's really a joy. I think it's a joy when you discover what your clients are benefit, how they're benefiting, and how any suggestions they have so that you can serve them even better. So hopefully that's pretty clear that why that's a joy to be able to receive customer client feedback. So anyway, I hope that just by talking through the seven disciplines again from the viewpoint of joy, you'll feel more interested in doing them and doing them consistently. Because if you do the seven disciplines consistently, you will have a successful, authentic business. That's how I've designed it. And that's how you'll discover as you do them that that's what happens. So if you have any questions, any comments, I look forward to seeing them. And right now I do want to go ahead and look at the live video that I'm doing right now to see if there are any comments from anyone about what I'm talking about thus far. And if you haven't yet commented, I'd love for you to comment. It does bring me joy to see your engagement with my videos. And I want to thank those of you who are joining me right now, Arturo and Harcharan and Paolo and Lorna and Joni and Amanda. And Lorna has offered a couple of comments here. So thank you, Lorna, for your comments here. Yes, playing at purposeful, painful progress. Yes. Yeah, you know, you just reframe the pain. Well, it's kind of like when you are, playing a video game. When you're playing a video game and you're up against a scary monster, you can interpret that as pain. Oh my God, it's so scary. This is going to be so scary. Or you can say, wow, this is so much fun. I'm playing this game and I'm learning how to beat this monster, you know, or learning how to jump from this cliff to the next cliff without falling and dying, you know? And so it really, life is a video game. You know, life is a simulation, right? We're in a virtual simulation right now where this is actually a simulation, or you might say this is a spirit in a body playing a physical third dimensional game, learning how to grow in virtues. That's really why we're here. We're learning how to become better spirits by using these bodies to overcome challenges, to solve problems, to overcome pains, to help each other, and all the while trying to bring spirit into these experiences, to play with how do we become better? How do we help each other? How do we love each other better? How do we help each other have less pain and have less suffering? You know, and so anyway, I hope we can all enjoy this process. And Amanda, thank you for your wonderful comment here. Yes, you do have to ask other people. If you just create content, make videos, make posts, and occasionally mention your products, not going to work. You have to invite them. You have to say, hey, that's why you notice what I do every Wednesday. Notice on my Facebook page. You can see it very plainly. Every Wednesday, I'm trying to sell you on something. Every Wednesday, I say, will you buy this? Or, hey, I'm about to sell you, right? Every single Wednesday, I'm either saying, will you play this game with me? I have a product. I'm about to create a product. And what do you think about it? Are you interested? You know, I'm kind of playing with you every Wednesday, dancing with you every Wednesday on my Facebook page. And it's like, hey, will you buy this? Hey, I'm about to sell this to you. What do you think? And, you know, and so I'm always testing. Hey, what do you think? And I see it as a very playful dancing kind of process, right? Paolo, thank you for your comment. Yeah, different ways to go through pain. Pain is not optional, but suffering is. Pain in this life is not, I mean, life. How did life even come to being? You being born created a lot of pain for your mother, okay? The pain was not optional. But of course, I'm not a birth expert, but maybe there are some spiritual, you know, more conscious birthing experts who can turn the birth of pain into a deeply joyful process. Probably, I can imagine that to be, but anyway, that's a very extreme example. Just to say that pain is not optional. So the kinds of business experts out there and marketing experts, all they show you is they're on vacation, they're driving great cars, they are drinking wonderful wines, and they are, you know, always having fun in their business. Not real. It's not how business, they're showing you 1 to 5% of their experience. They don't show you 95 to 99% of their experience, which is, okay, I got to launch this thing. Oh my God, I got to. And they're probably actually, many of them who just show you the fancy lifestyle have not learned to reframe their, you know, maybe they're just, oh, I gotta make the money so I can have the fancy lifestyle. But to me, this very moment of being with you on video, creating something, is to me a kind of a fancy lifestyle. I mean, what a privilege that I can make money by dancing with you, by creating something that might help you. I mean, that to me is, I'm living the lifestyle which I think is the best lifestyle. I go on one fancy vacation a year, fine, usually to visit family. I don't have the kind of lifestyle that you see on Instagram for people, but I am deeply enjoying my business creation most of the time. I think that's more important, to be enjoying the contribution we're making to others. And I wish more people did. So anyway, I hope this is helpful. And thank you, Vicky, also for joining me. And with that, I will end this video. I look forward to your comments and how you work the seven disciplines into the seven joys in your own authentic business. I wish you well. Take care.